Oh my gosh, you know what it is. What's up, YouTube? It is the season finale of season one here on STP 1440. Just that average college kid fixing and flipping weekly to turn $0 to $1,000 by the end of the season. Holy smokes, I hope you enjoy it. It's a good one. All right, so just to get you caught up, last week we got this Kawasaki Ninja for $400, got it torn down and diagnosed, spark checked out, compression checked out, so it's gotta be the carburetors. So before I cracked into the inside, I wanted to clean the outside of the car because this thing was all oxidized and dirty and it's just a pain to work with down the road. So we got it off and here's the before condition of the carburetor. And this carburetor is essentially just oxidized and rusted all over. So what rust is just oxygen from water reacting with the metal molecules of a surface. And what we're going to do is soak it in vinegar, and vinegar is acidic. So what it does is it surrounds those metal molecules and it dissociates them, which is another fancy way of saying it dissolves them. And so they brush right off and we have a clean surface. Within minutes of putting that thing in the vinegar, you can see it was already dissolving the oxide and rust right off the surface. Pretty sweet. Okay, so this has been soaking here for about 3 or 4 hours now, and after it's been soaking for a while, I'll just take a toothbrush and we're just gonna scrub a little bit of the carbon. I've already did a little bit here, but I hope you can appreciate. Look at that. That's like brand new now. Look over here. Look at that. It's like brand new. So we're just gonna scrub the whole carb and I'll show you the after. It's gonna be pretty cool. After, and you can see the surface is clean of oxide and no rust, and it's smooth and clean and shiny. And here's a side-by-side so you can really see the transformation. This is the exact same angle, same flash, there's no filters, so you can really see the difference. It really did a good job. All right, y'all, so we finally got our carb kit in the mail, and it's basically a bunch of screws, springs, gaskets, and little valves. And we've got our carb clean here on the outside, so we're gonna break into the inside. Literally just clean everything on the inside, replace all the components that come in the kit, put it back together, and we're gonna give it a shot. So I'm gonna time lapse the build for you just so you see it's not that hard, and I hope you enjoy.
The short and simple why carbs get gummed up is because if you let them sit for a while, modern gas has ethanol in it, which attracts water, and that water reacts with the metal components of the carburetors to form crystallization and oxidization inside. So you gotta clean out the inside just like the outside.
I wanted to show you guys, I'm just pulling this apart a little bit at the beginning, but like, for example, look at that gunk. That crap should not be in, look at that. That should not be in there, so it's a good thing we're cleaning this out, and I'm pretty sure it's gonna solve the problem, but back to the time lapse.
All right, so we got the carburetor finished being the rebuilt, so I had to reinstall it and see if it would fire up and see if I fixed it. So got it in, refilled the coolant, topped off the gas, and I sat there, man, I cranked and cranked and cranked for like 10 minutes, and I know that when you rebuild a carb, the bowl's got to fill back up with gas and everything, but this was way too long. So I was thinking and thinking, and then I realized, wait a minute, my little fuel source, the hose is hanging too low. So I picked it up and immediately air bubbles went into the bottle, which means that the carbs were filling up with gas because air was being exchanged with gas. And I was like, you gotta be kidding me, man. So I set the fuel up on a proper source, cranked it up, and the magic happened.
Always a great feeling when that thing fires up, man. It's a big rush. But now that we got it running, we got to make sure it's tuned in just right. So we had to make what's called a manometer out of some glass mason jars and hoses. I'll explain later what it does. All right, so here's our setup. And to describe it, we have our manometer. This is actually connected to the left cylinder. You can see the hose goes to the left. And this one's connected to the right cylinder because it goes to the right. And then we have our external fuel source, just a bottle going to the fuel intake. We want both cylinders to work equally. So what we're watching for is this water level. If the water level on one cylinder rises, that means that cylinder's doing more work because it's experiencing more vacuum pressure and sucking water from the other container. So what we want to do is we want to turn that adjustment screw toward the cylinder doing less work so that it does more work and evens out between the two.
So what we're gonna do is just keep adjusting while it's idling until these water levels maintain a constant level and are equal to each other. And that means both cylinders are doing the same amount of work. Let's try it out. So this thing we got it running is running crispy now, tuned up to a T, and time to take it for that test ride. And like I said, this is an iconic bike. It's actually the same bike Tom Cruise rode in Top Gun back in 1986. This one's just 21 years newer. So in a tribute to that, I think you guys will like my test ride, what I did to have a little fun. The bike was running awesome, so we put it up for sale, and after about a week or so of having it up there, shuffled through some buyers, and we found ourselves a winner. The guy was a local MMA fighter, and he came over, checked the bike out, loved it, and we ended up selling that bike for $2,300. So we went over and got the title signed, drove it over to his house, and since he had a car, I hauled it over there for him and unloaded it, and he loved it. He has himself an awesome Kawasaki Ninja. All right, y'all, let's check out the season finale finances. All right, with that $2,300 sale, that brings our profit to $1,757.48 for the last episode. What a way to go out, man. All right, let's check out the total for the season now. Last episode, we left off at $804.52 total profit. If we add that with this week's profit, that brings us to a grand total of $2,562. Oh my gosh, what a season. Starting from a free rocking chair. Holy smokes.
Yo, let's go.
Man, we crushed that $1,000 goal. Man, started out with nothing and just built it from there. The season was a blast, man. But no sky too high, no sea too rough. I don't see why we should stop now. I'm calling it season two. We're turning $1,000. Into $5,000. Let's get it. It's happening. Just wait. But man, I just want to close out this season saying there's 1,440 minutes in every day makes a change. And it's funny because change is money, but change also means make a difference. And at the end of the day, it's people that matters, man. I mean, you know, be a light, seek and save, share a smile. Just having the smallest positive impact on somebody can mean the world to them and you never even know it. But with that being said, I wanted to give a huge thanks to the people coming up. They had a really positive impact on me and really supported me on my journey and made it happen. And big thanks to you guys. But with that being said, until season two, as you know, STP 1440, out.